Hey guys, Robert Field here from Field Trips and one of the developers of the new Strike from Lightning Kayaks. We're extremely excited about this new boat. And right now I'm gonna walk you guys through the boat, all the features, the hull, the performance, everything about it from bow to stern. So first off, let me tell you why we decided to build this boat. The pedal drive revolution of kayaks has been all the rage. It is an extremely efficient way to move around on the water. It keeps your hands free, whether you're fishing or enjoying photography or bird watching, whatever the case may be. But like with any new technology, it's been overly expensive since it was introduced to the market. So a good friend of mine that owns a paddle company called me up and said, "Rob, I want to build the ultimate pedal drive kayak, not cut any corners, but do it at a price that the average person can actually afford. And I want to build them right here in the USA. Do you think you can help?" And so that's what we've done. So this is the only premium rotomolded sit on top kayak with a fin style drive in this price point. We're extremely excited about it. So let's quickly go over the overall specs of the boat. The Strike is 12 foot 6 inches long. It's 34 inches wide. It weighs about 80 pounds and it has a carrying capacity of about 400 pounds. Now let's talk about performance. Let's talk about the hull, how we designed this boat to efficiently move through the water. So it's got essentially a kind of catamaran or tri-hull design. What that allows is for some extreme stability. So standing up in this boat is no problem. You're gonna be able to take it out in some rough water, some waves, some wind, whatever you need to, and not have to worry about turning this thing over. So that tri-hull design is also gonna kind of minimize the surface area up at the bow, which is gonna reduce water resistance and allow you to go faster, especially when you're using our Freedom Drive. So this is a pedal drive kayak. It is a fin style drive, not a propeller. So you basically move your legs back and forth. The fins go side to side, and because one edge of the fin is rigid and one edge has some flex to it, that allows for forward propulsion. The nicest thing about these fin style drives is that there's no experience or form required. So with a traditional paddle kayak, having good paddling form is essential for efficient movement, especially over long distances. But with this, literally anyone can hop in, start pedaling, and just go. So when we were designing this hull, we wanted to pack as many features and kind of conveniences throughout the hull as possible. So we'll start with the handles. These sit on top kayaks, they tend to be kind of heavier than traditional lighter craft. So we wanted to make sure that the handles were sturdy and that they were going to be durable enough to last a long time. So we didn't want one that was drilled into the boat. We wanted it molded right into the boat. So at the bow and the stern, there are some thick molded in handles. They fit really nicely in your hand. You don't have to worry about pulling anything out of the boat, which I've had happen in the past with other boats. On the sides, there's also two handles kind of molded into the side gunnels. That's gonna allow you to pick up this boat with one hand on your side, walk it down to the water when you need to. We also molded two cup holders right into the gunnels so you don't have to bring some aftermarket cup holder, and they're self-draining. So they're not gonna fill up with water and hold water throughout the day. So we designed this hull to specifically work well with the Freedom Drive, but we also wanted to make sure that it was efficient when paddled. There's gonna be times when you're in shallow water or getting in and out of thick stuff or going down rapids, whatever the case may be, and the hull is extremely efficient when paddled traditionally. And along those lines, we molded in multiple footrests on either side of the Freedom Drive, and that's gonna allow you to brace your legs against that to give you good core strength while you're paddling over long distances. So when you separate your feet with the Freedom Drive, the fins lay flat against the bottom of the boat. And we molded in recesses on either side to reduce your draft so you can get into even skinnier water. So speaking of the Freedom Drive, the key to any pedal drive is having an effective rudder. We molded ours into the back of the boat, and then with the release of a simple pull cord, it drops down to give you a really tight turning radius. Now in this edition of the Strike, we also molded in areas where we have put down EVA foam padding on the deck. And that provides two benefits. One, it provides comfort while you're standing up all day, whether you're fishing or just stretching, whatever that case may be. And two, it also makes the deck quieter. So if you are fishing and you drop stuff down on the deck, it's not gonna make a big clunking sound and scare away the fish. Another key thing with any kayak, no matter what you're using it for, is storage. So we molded in a large front hatch that's perfect for anything you may need on the water, whether that's camping gear, fishing gear, picnic supplies, a football, a frisbee, you name it. It's a really large tank well. You could even put rods in there and store them inside the hull whenever necessary. It secures down with two bungees, very simple, very easy to get in and out of. And because the boat's so stable, it's no problem kind of crawling forward and getting stuff out of there. For things you need to access more frequently, we also included an 8-inch hatch right in front of your seat. It twists off really easily, and that's perfect for kind of items you're gonna be grabbing throughout the day. So in addition to the two hatches, we also designed in a really large rear tank well, which is gonna be perfect for anything from the NRS Ambush tackle bag. If you're out fishing and need your tackle and rod holders, you could put a cooler back there. You could really fit even a small soft cooler in here in addition to this crate. Really tons of room back there for anything that you may need on the water. And you can reach back there and access it from your seat, no problem. So now let's talk about the features. So I have this rigged out currently for fishing. I'm a kayak angler, so that's what I use this thing for primarily. But this is the perfect boat for any other activity you'd want to do on the water. Whether that's photography or bird watching or just taking the family out for a camping trip or a picnic or even a quick morning workout. And because this boat is so versatile, we wanted to make sure that you could kind of rig it out however you need to for whatever you happen to be doing on the water. The Strike is going to come with pre-installed gear tracks, two up by the Freedom Drive in front of you, and four surrounding the rear tank well. These are going to allow you to mount any accessories from a variety of companies that you may need. Now I've got Railblazer Star ports rigged up in the front and in the back, and that allows me to move different accessories around depending on what my needs are for any particular trip. So I've got my fish finder rigged up here, rod holder, safety flag and a light, a camera boom so I can capture the action for my show. And really these are like Legos. You can move them around. They also make cell phone holders. So if you just want something to play music or maybe record you for your Facebook page, whatever the case may be, you can really kind of rig this thing out to enhance your time on the water no matter what you're doing. There's two paddle keeps, one on each side of the gunwale so you can keep your paddle handy, whichever side is more convenient for you. The seat is a lawn chair style seat, so it's gonna be extremely comfortable over a long day on the water, and it's extremely easy to get it in and out of the boat and also to switch positions. There's just one strap and one buckle right in front of you between your legs. You loosen that up and you can easily move it back and forth. There's also straps running along the bottom of the seat that you can tighten to give you more support here and there to make sure that it's a comfortable fit for you. The seat has three different positions, two low positions and a high position in the middle. So the high position is going to give you a better vantage point, better visibility in the water. That's going to be perfect if you're fishing. The two low positions are going to give you a little bit lower center of gravity for even more stability, but I've been running it pretty much exclusively in the high position and stability has not been an issue. This thing is rock solid. The other nice thing about the three seat positions is that they move horizontally, and that coupled with the fact that the Freedom Drive has about eight different positions where you can adjust how far the pedals are from you means that this boat is going to accommodate people of a wide range of heights. The Strike's also going to come stock with two flush mount rod holders in the back. These have covers on them so you can cover them up when you're not using them to make sure water's not sitting in there. But that makes for a really convenient place to put some rod holders if you don't want to go get some aftermarket accessories. The rear tank will also come stock with some bungee there to secure your gear down if you're in rough water or whatever the case may be. And we made the two middle attachment points hooks so that you can easily undo that bungee. So if you need to get it out of the way for whatever reason, so it comes off in a snap and then just secures right back down when you need it again. So with our focus on this boat being keeping the price point at a reasonable level, we made sure to focus on the features that we thought were important and then skipped the superficial ones that aren't that useful. So we did not put a rear hatch in this boat. Rear hatches are typically inaccessible on the water. They're not that useful. And so we wanted to save that cost and pass that down to the consumer. But we did make sure to design in an access plate for the rudder so that if for some reason you do have issues with the rudder, it is possible to get in there and make any repairs or adjustments that you may need. So speaking of the rudder, you drop it down once you get out on the water by simply releasing the pull cord from the cleat. It drops down on its own weight. And the nice thing about that is if you run into an underwater obstacle, like a log or rocks, the rudder is gonna pop up on its own so it doesn't get damaged and then pop right back down once you clear that obstacle. The steering lever is on the left-hand side. It's extremely easy to turn. You can easily do it with a couple fingers, so you're not gonna feel fatigue in your hand over a long day. And we also designed in kind of a dummy rudder lever on the right-hand side so that if you wanna switch that over, if you're left-handed or right-handed, you can use whichever side is more comfortable for you. So that is the Lightning Kayak Strike in a nutshell. Now, as a professional kayak angler, this is not a hobby for me. This is my full-time job. So it was imperative for me that we delivered the highest quality kayak at a reasonable price. And I'm excited to say that we hit a home run. So the Strike is available for pre-order right now on our Indiegogo campaign at a price point that will never be seen again. So if you're in the market for a new kayak, whether it's for chasing your favorite fish, getting some exercise, or just spending some quality time with your family on the water, now is the perfect time to go online and pre-order your Strike.